vague rumors began to circulate around
the playground, in the classroom, in the lunchroom. All filled 11-year-olds whispering corridors. Could it be true? The holy grail of every modern child's possessions. The ultimate gadget. The everything we could ever want. The iPads were going to be a part of our new lives. As these whispers of school were certified by email, our minds blew. We could only imagine the possibilities. Games. Games galore. Games all day and all night. From arcade to adventure, racing to roleplay, strategy to simulation. These iPads were a portal to virtual heaven. We soon found out this was not going to be the case. But these iPads would be our very own. Up until then, any glimpse of screen time for our parents themselves would have been strictly regulated by parents. The firmware shared with our families, and especially siblings. These iPads would be entirely off-limits from pestering bugs and systems. The exciting first week of class at our new friends. With new friends, new teachers, and new everything. But the real question that captured our minds was, when will we get our iPads? Finally, the day arrived. Handed down in alphabetical order, which proved unpopular to some, my son. The iPads were given out, followed by gasps and gaping jaws. Despite orders not to open until we got home, temptation was not too great for some, sneaking peeks inside the pristine packaging to the wonders within. Following the strict guidelines provided in the instructions booklet, we retreated to our bedrooms to set them up before the unveiling to our families of our new digital friends. School the next day was amazing. As the first to get them, Year 7s proudly showed them off to the older kids, and lessons were filled with fun presentations and quizzes. Even the teachers seemed to be having fun. After a week or two, the fun really began, however. With newfound courage, plucky individuals runs rings around some teachers who are less tech savvy, as the capabilities of airdrop and airplane became apparent to students. We nearly could air into college. And they were rarely poor. It was the perfect crime, and many people became infamous for listening on the iPads. This soon died down, however, as people saw how the iPads could really be used to help us learn. In fact, the use of the iPads helped us live up to our school motto of doing ordinary things extraordinarily well. In time, everybody got to grips with the new tech, and soon the iPads had become another part of school life, one of the best. The practicalities of certain elements of the iPads are really great for making life easier. For example, we have good notes and pages that allow us to type or write or write our work in a place that can't be lost. Folder is a great way for storing notes for our revision for our future exams and allows us to save our work in the long term. Journal, homework and a calendar are brilliant ways to keep organized and stay ahead of the paper. And Shobi is a brilliant way for teachers to share documents, give feedback and mark pieces of work as needed, easily and instantaneously. Lots of our textbooks are also now on the iPads, which is simpler and puts everything in one place on websites like Google. The use of iPads has also really positively changed the way we revise. We have access to all of our old revision notes, as well as new ways to use them, like Poplar, a mind map app, or the text flashcards app. Everybody loves the quizzes we do in school on apps like Socrative, and Nearpod. They allow us to work under a time pressure, in a fun environment, and especially against our peers, as well as sending the results straight to the teacher on a spreadsheet. As a boys' school, everybody is massively competitive, and these apps allow those who aren't amazing on the football field to race with the top in a different situation. This way of teaching and learning is informative, memorable, and best of all, fun. Other benefits in school of the iPad include the ability to record and video things in subjects like the languages, drama, and even PE, downloading books to read, an email account we can get used to checking regularly, as well as the ability to search and research on the internet, be it the spelling or definition of a word, or extra information on a historical topic or science paper. The iPads are an amazing way to improve our learning in general and fit perfectly into our school and home lives. They really help us do ordinary things extraordinarily well.
Congratulations, that's Malachi.